Monster Jam fans here in Orlando and those tuning in from across the country and around the world streaming live, welcome to the inaugural Monster Jam Hall of Fame ceremony. Tonight, we are proud to celebrate two extraordinary people whose incredible achievements have shaped the past, present, and future of Monster Jam. Tonight, we begin tonight's ceremonies where both of our inductees in familiar roles. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our Monster Jam Hall of Fame inductee, Scott Douglas.
Thanks, Kay. It is a tremendous honor to be here to kick off the inaugural Monster Jam Hall of Fame induction ceremony, and it's a tremendous honor to do it by making this special introduction. An introduction of a man who has won so many racing competitions right here in Orlando and has turned in some of his most spectacular freestyle performances right here on the floor behind me. Monster Jam fans, please direct your attention to the entrance to the track here at Camping World Stadium as he takes one more lap around the stadium for you fans. Please welcome the first inductee into the Monster Jam Hall of Fame, the icon, Gravediggers Dennis Anderson.
Wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad to the bone, bad, 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 bad,
Monster Jam fans, let's hear it for your inaugural Monster Jam Hall of Fame inductees, Dennis Anderson and Scott Douglas. And now as we begin our induction ceremonies, please direct your attention to the video board.
For nearly three decades and counting, we have witnessed Monster Jam grow to be the birthplace of legends, where the valiant have vied for victory, their mighty machines pushing the limits atop earthen mounds of invention, hallowed grounds where championships were waged, won, and lost. These pioneers, these icons, have dedicated their lives to the sport. Extraordinary men and women who shaped Monster Jam into a phenomenon around the globe. At last, their feats, their triumphs, their histories have a home. A place where courage, ingenuity, and excellence are realized and rewarded. A place where legends and heroes can live on forever. The Monster Jam Hall of Fame.
Again, a big welcome to the Monster Jam fans here in Orlando and those tuning in across the country and around the world streaming live. For nearly 30 years, Monster Jam has been top of the motorsports world. Millions of fans worldwide have enjoyed the world's best driver athletes compete at the highest level and witness the amazing technology revolution that gives Monster Jam trucks its superpower that defies physics and soar to unimaginable heights. The Monster Jam Hall of Fame recognizes those individuals who have heart, passion, and dedication have left lasting remarks on our sport, and those who contributions have also continually redefined what Monster Jam is, what it was, and what it will be forever. We're so privileged to spend the evening with the first two inductees, their families, and distinguished guests in a celebration of achievement. Tonight, we honor Dennis Anderson, the icon, the creator of the Gravedigger Monster Jam truck, a four-time World Finals champion, and the driver widely regarded of developing the freestyle competition as it's known today. We also honor Scott Douglas, the voice of Monster Jam, a live event and television host whose knowledge, passion, and ambassadorship have entertained and informed millions. It is my pleasure to introduce to the stage Adam, Ryan, and Kristen Anderson.
Well, there are many great qualities that I love about my dad, but my favorite quality of his is how wholeheartedly he believes in himself. I have yet to meet another person in the whole world that believes in themselves and their ideas as hard as Dennis Anderson does. And as much as those big ideas and aspirations have pushed this family's sanity to its limit at times, I admire his courage he has to take those risks. And I wish I had inherited more of that fearless confidence of his, truly. People, the hardest thing for them is believing in themselves. And look what happened when my dad did. My dad created this crazy lifestyle for all of us, and he has become a hero to millions of people along the way. And I know he's my hero. So to me, there is no better person to be inducted into the Hall of Fame than my dad.
There's no doubt this is an emotional event for us as the Andersons because this is our lives. Every day of our life, from day one, Adam grew up with a crib in the hauling rig for Gravedigger that was made from a school bus. But one of my favorite stories about Dad, one of the things that shaped Monster Jam to be what it is, was my dad's truck could barely hold together. He could barely afford to get to the events. He actually spent 100% of his money just to get to this event, where he broke down immediately. He didn't want to disappoint his fans. He didn't want to disappoint anybody that supported Gravedigger, and he also needed to get home. He won no money. He was totally broke, so he asked the promoter, he said, "Can I take my truck out here and do something crazy with it just for my fans? I want my fans to love me and buy my t-shirts and support me so I can get home." And that's just what he did. He did what was the first ever Monster Jam freestyle. He went out there hitting things backwards, doing crazy stuff that's never been seen before, and created the biggest, baddest thing in the world. I don't care where you go, what you see, you don't get action like you get at Monster Jam, and that's because my dad, Dennis Anderson, the creator of Gravedigger, the creator of all of us, the creator of Son of a Digger, all the good stuff. Dennis Anderson, the baddest dude to ever live, ever get in a Monster Jam truck, period. Thank you, Monster Jam fans.
You know, we talk about all the things that that was done off of the track, and all that was done for every one of you guys. He pushed and strived to make sure the fans were happy. Sometimes we weren't, but that was okay with Dad, because the Monster Jam fans, which became part of our family, they were happy with what happened on the track with him and off. But for now, I want everybody to take their attention to the video screen and see those reasons why.
Dennis Anderson to me is a guy that everyone looked up to. He's the guy that put the freestyle in freestyle.
He's the innovator. You know, he's the creator of Gravedigger and so many of the elements that we see in our sport today.
He crashed out more than anybody else in the world. That's a guarantee. I don't even have to look it up. He would crash out because he knew that's what the fans wanted to see.
He developed the standard for loving and respecting the fans, and the fans loving and respecting him in return, which created a really, really deep connection between him and the millions of Gravedigger fans worldwide.
Without him, what would we be doing right now? I have no idea.
There wouldn't be Monster Jam.
Dennis Anderson is the top of the top. He's done this for wonders, and I'm stoked for him for sure.
When I was his crew chief, it really meant a lot to me, and he stood behind me 100%. I'm just so proud of him getting to this honor of being in the Moss Jam Hall.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dennis Anderson!
Wow. It's probably the best ring I've gotten, man, since the FFA back when I was in high school. It was the only ring I ever got in my life other than a wedding ring. And this baby right here is juicy. It is awesome. And I just want to thank you guys. You know, from my family to my fans, it's been quite a journey. I never thought in a million years that I would go this far, this long, and be an All-American guy playing trucks all of my life, all of my adult life, man. And I just got to say, man, that, you know, these guys right here, I honestly didn't think that they would even follow my footsteps. I was out playing trucks, making everybody else's kids happy. My kids were home playing soccer, school plays. I missed it all. I wasn't there, and I just figured, especially this guy, the oldest one, he was going to smarten up and say, I'm not going to be like the old man. He's never home. And I was always dedicated to that truck. And for some reason, I always had more patience with my fans than I did with my family. But, you know, that's not a bad thing. I learned a lot. I taught these guys a lot, and I got to tell you, man, you never know what life is going to bring you. You got to step it out. You got to take chances in life, take a risk, put it all on the line, and I did. And here I am almost 40 years later, standing trackside, watching my family carry on a legacy. I'm not done. It's one of those moments in life. It only comes one time. And I got to tell you guys, it's a very proud moment. And I did not do this by myself. You guys were a big part of success. For Gravedigger, Dennis Anderson, Monster Jam, you guys are the pioneers of tailgating party for Monster Jam, and it happened right here in Orlando. There are so many good memories here, and I got a few bad ones, but I got to tell you, man, in my book, I marked this in my book back in the mid-90s. Florida was the number one fan base for Dennis Anderson and Gravedigger. Orlando has always been Gravedigger's house. I don't care how many times Tom Mintz beat me or tried to beat me. This was still my house, Tom. But man, I got to tell you guys, I'm not done. I have grandkids. I have a younger son that a lot of you people don't even know, Weston Anderson. He is a new up-and-coming superstar. I am proud of my whole family. My daughter, I never thought would ever drive a truck. And we miss her at the dungeon and at the diner. So whenever she wants to stop playing trucks and come home, that would be very helpful. I love you, sweetheart. I love all of you guys. And I want to thank y'all for every nut and bolt on my truck and every shingle on my roof. Orlando, Monster Jam is here to stay.
Congratulations to you,
Dennis. I think my times are up. We need to move on. We have a show to do and a few other things. But like I said, this only happens one time, so I'm going to burn it down. Freestyle is on the way, so I'm going to let somebody else talk for a while. Love you guys. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Once again, congratulations to you, Dennis, on the behalf of your millions of fans worldwide. Congratulations on this historic induction to the Monster Jam Hall of Fame. Now I'd like to introduce to the stage Monster Jam on NBC's Pit Reporter, Leslie Mears.
So what can you say about a man who has been the voice of Monster Jam for over 3 decades? Nothing. He's already spoken all the memorable words. Many people think that Scott's greatest attribute and his biggest contribution to Monster Jam has been his unmistakable booming voice. No matter where you were or when you heard it, you knew it was time for Monster Jam. It's truly unforgettable. But in reality, his greatest attribute is his selflessness. He shared his wealth of knowledge with every host that has ever held a microphone in Monster Jam. He's helped every driver, whether up and coming or a wily veteran, tell their own unique story in the best way possible. Throughout the years, he's been able to make the light shine a little brighter on those he's worked with. And while the time on this mic is limited now, just know that every time you hear the live call from the host at Monster Jam, or listen to the play-by-play host call the action on TV, you're still hearing the voice of the legend living on through those with whom he has selflessly shared his knowledge.
The voice of Monster Jam.
The voice.
The voice of voice.
The voice of Monster Jam.
Welcome to Sam Boyd Stadium. I'm Scott Douglas.
Momentum at the end. Are you kidding me?
Scott Douglas to me is an icon. A legend, the greatest of all time. When it comes to Monster Jam announcers, there was nobody better than Scott.
Oh, no, he did. No, he did. Did you see that?
So when I think of Monster Jam, yeah, of course I think of all the incredible drivers that we've had over the years. But for me, when I think of Monster Jam, I think of Scott Douglas.
Scott Douglas is a sharp man on his game. He is a walking encyclopedia of Monster Jam knowledge. And he knows so much about it because he's lived it. He was there.
Absolutely unbelievable, off the charts.
He's literally lived our entire legacy and our entire history on the front lines by telling the world what's going on.
Scott Douglas belongs in the Hall of Fame because when you hear his voice,
the place is standing.
You associate that immediately with Monster Jam.
It is now my privilege to present to you your Hall of Fame inductee, the voice of Monster Jam, Scott Douglas. Scott Douglas.
Like Dennis said, wow.
That is beautiful. You get a look at that, man.
The Monster Jam Hall of Fame. Just those words. When I heard them a little over a year ago, that there was going to be a Monster Jam Hall of Fame created, I was so excited. There's so much history over this quarter century, so many people who have contributed so much and who are going to deserve and who someday will be standing in this spot to be inducted in the Hall of Fame. And I was excited. I never dreamed that I'd be standing here in the inaugural Hall of Fame class next to the man, the myth, the legend himself, Dennis Anderson. This is, without question, the highest honor of my professional career, and I'm just so thankful right now to everybody. And I'm just take a minute. I know we got show to get to, and I want to the event. I want to see it too, but I do want to thank a few people who I wouldn't be standing here without. You know, the kid who, well, I wasn't a kid, but I was still pretty young in my career. In 1988, at Louisville Motor Speedway on that famous Monster Truck figure eight track. And the first time I saw these trucks, I knew they were special, and I knew I wanted to be a part of it. And God has blessed me for more than 30 years by being able to do just that, to take this journey with you fans, with the most incredible athletes that you'll ever meet, and an unbelievable team that a lot of you never see and you never know about. So I'm just going to take a minute to thank them. And that starts with everybody in Monster Jam at Feld Entertainment, the Feld family, all the executives and the directors, but everybody who works for that company and works tirelessly, and I mean everybody, I can't mention them all, but whether it's a tech official, an event manager, the people in the office, everybody pulls together to make sure that you fans get the greatest world-class motorsport and entertainment all rolled into one package. So I thank everybody I've ever worked with and who's been a part of it. I want to give a special thanks, though, to a couple of groups that have made a big impact on my career. All of the producers and editors and videographers and everybody who's involved with putting together the Monster Jam television shows that I've been a part of. I've been proud of every one of them. I've worked with some amazing and talented professionals. And in the live event world, it's the AV team. Those voices in my ears that always keep us on point, making sure you fans know what's happening, what's special, and what's spectacular about watching these Monster Jam trucks. I couldn't be here without my family. Two of my daughters, Blair and Lindsay, are here. The rest of the family is watching on the live stream. Thanks, Feld, for putting it up and letting everybody see it. But you know, you can't do something like this without a great family. And Roxanne and my daughters and my grandchildren have done nothing but support me for 3 weeks in South Africa or going to Japan or China on this amazing and wild journey. And I couldn't do without them and love my family dearly. To the Monster Jam hosts, everyone that I've worked with over the years, it's been an honor. So many great professionals, both on TV and in live events. And then in recent years, the ones I've had the opportunity to work with in a training capacity. Greg Whitaker's here tonight. It's such an honor. Greg and I have worked side by side with Jessica Ferris and others to search the country, auditioning, casting, and training. And what we're trying to do and what we have been able to do is find world-class talent and convince them they want to be a part of taking Monster Jam to the next level. And I hope every one of those hosts sees me standing here and realizes what an impact the host on the announcer, the person who is telling the fans why this event is so special and why these folks are so special is. So I hope it inspires all of you. A big thanks to every driver I've ever worked with and every crew chief. I watched your passion. I watched how hard you worked to continue the event, and that made me work harder. But last but certainly not least, my biggest thanks goes to the Monster Jam fans. Obviously, we're not here without all of you, but it's more than that. Other sports have fans. They don't have Monster Jam fans. The most dedicated, passionate, loving fans, and we become family. You know, there's so many special fans. I know some who are special to me. The Mumpower family and Jackie and Jacob flew down here from Virginia. You see my Monster Jam tie. Only two of us I know have this because Jacob made him, gave me one. He has the other. That's the kind of fans we have in Monster Jam, and that's the kind of fans that always drove me to want to make the experience special for you. And now what I want to do is go ahead and get out of the way because I know about you. I'm looking for an epic freestyle, and I want to see some serious elevation, Holmes. You got that? So let me just wrap it up by saying one more thing. An epic freestyle is coming up. My final words to you. Orlando, who's ready for Monster Jam?
Scott, congratulations on this incredible achievement. Monster Jam fans, it is my great honor to present to the world, the inaugural class of Monster Jam's Hall of Fame, Dennis Anderson and Scott Douglas. Yeah.